In this video, we're going to discuss lapping. So lapping is a fraud scheme, and in particular, it's a type of skimming. Skimming is any type of scheme where someone is removing cash from the company before it's ever even recorded in the accounting system. Now, what's unique about lapping is that the perpetrator, the person committing the fraud, after they steal the money, they're actually going to take money from another customer's account to cover it up so that nobody finds out. Let me give you an example. So let's say that there's a customer, customer A, they owe your company $8,000, and then they mail your company a check for $8,000. So it should be that their balance goes to zero, right? Because they just paid $8,000, they owed $8,000, they should have a balance of zero. However, the employee at your company who's in charge of opening the mail and so forth, they steal the $8,000. They take the check and they end up getting it cashed, and they take the $8,000 for themselves. So instead of this customer's balance being zero, instead it's going to be $8,000 still, because it doesn't reflect that this employee stole the money, so that never gets credited against this customer's account. So what is going to happen? Well, in a week or two or so forth, customer A is going to get a notice from your company saying, hey, you never paid this balance of $8,000. Now, the person who committed the fraud, who stole the $8,000, they are aware of that. So they say, okay, what is going to, you know, this person is going to be told, hey, you didn't pay the $8,000. And they're going to say, yes, we did. Here's the check number and so forth. And then the fraud is going to be discovered. So what this employee is going to do with lapping, they say, well, I need to somehow conceal this so that in a few weeks, this customer doesn't get a notice saying, hey, you owe $8,000. And instead this never even comes to that customer's attention. So what they do is they get the next check. Okay, so the next check comes in the mail from customer B. And let's say customer B owed $10,000. Okay, so they take that $10,000 and they take $8,000 of it and apply it to customer A's balance. Okay, so they're stealing now $10,000. So they stole the initial $8,000. Then the next customer check from customer B comes in of $10,000 and they take eight of that and applies it against the balance of customer A. So from your company's accounting records now, customer A, their balance is zero. Okay, so their balance is zero. So you basically stole from customer B to pay customer A. So customer A is never going to get a notice from your company saying, hey, where's the $8,000? Because from your company's accounting system perspective, they have paid their bill. But now the issue is customer B, at some point customer B is going to get a notice saying, hey, where's your money and so forth, because this money was stolen. So then the employee is going to have to steal from customer C and customer D and so forth. So the fraud just continues and continues. They're basically getting, as new checks come in the mail, they steal those and they credit them against the prior customer's account. So they're constantly stealing from customers, but using the new money from customers to credit the prior customer's balance so that no one ever finds out about this. Hey, and you could prevent lapping. One way is through segregation of duties. For example, if the person who opens the mail, if that person is the same person who records, so they open the mail, they record the cash receipts, they apply it against the customer's accounts, if they have control over all those different functions, then it's easy for them to commit this lapping scheme. But however, let's just say that the person who opens the mail, that's one person, but then the person in charge of crediting customer accounts and saying, okay, customer A paid this, customer B paid this. Let's say that those are two different employees. Then one person cannot commit this lapping scheme. That's not to say you couldn't still have this fraud going on. You would need collusion, right? If this employee and this employee were working together, you know, we call that collusion, multiple employees, then you could still have the fraud. But when you segregate the duties and one person is not able to perform all those different functions, you have different employees doing different things, you prevent one person from being able to commit this lapping scheme.